The ANTECH far-field gamma monitor is designed to measure radioactive waste in drums with a range of radioactivity content and waste density. The purpose of the measurement is to determine the inventory of radionuclides contained in the drum or object being measured. ANTECH far-field gamma monitor series G3600 instruments employ the far-field or single-shot measurement process for measuring waste drums or objects. The drum is measured using a high-purity germanium detector, where the entire drum is in the detector field of view. During the measurement, the drum is rotated and a single gamma ray spectrum is obtained. The drum density is calculated from the measured weight. The G3600 incorporates several novel features: a drum rotation platform incorporating drum weight measurement, a conical trapezoidal steel collimator placed in front of the germanium detector, a detector shelf mounted on slide rails to automate the adjustment of the drum to detector distance, automated filters for detector dose rate reduction, and drum dose rate scanning using Geiger-Müller detectors. An optional drum barcode reader may also be incorporated. The measurement method is applicable to waste streams where the waste matrix and activity distribution are nearly homogeneous. The far-field measurement method is the most sensitive method for measuring low-activity drums with relatively low density. It is also appropriate for measuring high-density or very high-activity drums with high gamma-ray dose rates. For drums with intermediate density and a higher degree of matrix heterogeneity, more accurate measurements can often be obtained using the segmented gamma scanner method. Waste drums, which are typically 200 liters or 55 US gallons, or alternatively 400 liters in volume, are placed on the drum rotation platform. The drum rotation platform incorporates a load cell to measure the drum weight, from which the density of the material in the drum or the drum matrix can be determined. This density information is employed by the far-field analysis method to correct for gamma-ray attenuation in the drum matrix material. Typically, one or two Geiger-Müller dose rate detectors are incorporated into the design. They are positioned to determine the drum surface dose rate. This information is used to establish the measurement conditions, including the use of filters or the movement of the detector away from the drum, to reduce the count rate in the detector and hence the detector dead time. Two Geiger-Müller dose rate detectors are used if the waste drums or waste object being measured are expected to have a wide range of radioactivity, resulting in a wide range of dose rate. The far-field gamma monitor employs a high-purity germanium detector, which is housed in a cylindrical lead shield. A conical trapezoidal steel collimator is placed in front of the germanium detector to reduce the radiation background and ensure that the detected gamma rays come only from the drum or object being measured. Based on the measurement made by the Geiger-Müller dose rate detectors, for very high dose rate drums, the high purity germanium detector may be moved further away from the drum to reduce the count rate in the detector. In addition, two automated tungsten filters are incorporated into the body of the collimator. Either one or other filter will be deployed if the drum contains even higher activity, resulting in a higher dose rate. Comprehensive motion control electronics based on an Allen Bradley Programmed Logic Controller, or PLC, are incorporated to control the drum rotation, the deployment of the tungsten filters, and the movement of the detector. The electronics have been simplified in that a single cable carrying both power and signal is used to connect all the motor drives in the electronics cabinet with the motion control motors. All communication within the instrument is by means of Ethernet. Two important assumptions of the far-field measurement process are that the matrix material in the drum is uniform and of constant density, and that the radioactivity being measured is uniformly distributed throughout the drum. As long as these assumptions of homogeneity are observed in general, and the deviations are not great, measurement errors will be small. Rotating the drum helps to reduce the error that would arise if a drum has radial inhomogeneity in either the matrix or the distribution of radioactivity. The far-field gamma monitor is supplied with a factory calibration which incorporates a benchmarked MCNP Monte Carlo model of the detector response, measuring a europium 152 calibration point source. This source is traceable to international standards. The calibration is verified and validated at the factory using calibrated and traceable line sources, which accurately simulate a distributed source in a drum. The measurement process, including both calibration and background measurement, is automated using operator software that reduces the time required to set up a measurement and simplifies operator training. Measurement data is archived, and data analysis and reanalysis is simple.